Welcome to our channel Competition Grid. Here we are going to discuss current affairs daily. So please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon to get further notification. Now I am discussing both the Sunday as well as Monday current affairs here. Okay, first question. Union Human Resource Minister Ramesh Pokhriyal has made amendment in Prime Minister Research Fellowship, that is PMRF scheme, to boost research in country. Who is Minister of State of HRD Ministry? He is Sanjay Dhotre. Union Minister is Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank. He is from constituency Haridwar of Uttarakhand. Minister of State is Sanjay Dhotre. He is from constituency Akola of Maharashtra. Union Human HRD Minister Nishank announced various modifications and amendments in the Prime Minister Research Fellowship schemes to boost research in the country and also enable more students to avail the benefit under the scheme. Next one, Central Board of Direct Taxes has amended Rule 44G of Income Tax Rules 1962 recently. Who is the chairman of the Central Board of Direct Taxes? He is P.C. Modi. If you talk about P.C. Modi means Pramod Chandra Modi, headquarters located in New Delhi, established in 1924. Next, Sikkim government has passed the budget comprises of rupees 9,100 for financial year 2021. Who is the chief minister of Sikkim? He is Prem Singh Tamang. Sikkim Legislative Assembly with a 32-member state legislature passed a budget of 9,100 crores for financial year 2021. Okay, if you talk about Sikkim, capital is Gangtok. Already we discussed PM is Prem Singh Tamang. Governor is Ganga Prasad. Okay, next one. The central government has launched India's biggest evacuation plan to bring back Indian citizens stranded in foreign countries. What was the name of the mission? That is Vande Bharat Mission. Okay. This Vande Bharat Mission is a massive repatriation operation planned by the Indian government to bring back stranded Indians in different parts of the world in the wake of coronavirus crisis. In the first phase of the started, that is on May 7th, more than 60 non-scheduled commercial flights will operate from the 12 countries to bring back 15,000 citizens. In the second phase of Vande Bharat Mission, and in the third week of May, it is expected to cover European nations, especially on European nations. Okay, next one. Which Indian metro city has registered the highest number of internet users in accordance with the study by the Internet and Mobile Association in India? That is IAMAI. The state is Mumbai. As per the study by the Internet and Mobile Association of India, among the metro cities, Mumbai has the highest internet population of 13 million and a growth of 12%. Delhi had 11.3 million while Bengaluru had 6.6 million along with 6.2 million in Kolkata and 6 million in Chennai. Next one, for the 40th anniversary of eradication of which disease, the World Health Organization and United Nations Postal Agency has released the commemorative postage stamp, that is smallpox. The World Health Organization WHO and UN Postal Agency released a commemorative postage stamp on the 40th anniversary of the eradication of smallpox. Okay, next one. The central government has raised the estimated gross market borrowing crore for financial year 21 as per the budget estimates from 7.80 lakh crore to how much? That is 12 lakh crore. If you talk about financial minister, that is union minister, is Nirmala Sitharaman. She is from constituency of Karnataka. Minister of State is Anurag Singh Thakur. He is from constituency of Hamirpur, Himachal Pradesh. Next one, the Union Finance Minister Nirmala Sitharaman launched rupee futures and options contracts on two international exchanges, namely India's INX BSE and NSE IFC NSE, that is dollar. Headquarters located in New Delhi, that is Ministry of Finance. Ministry of State is Anurag Singh Thakur. Next one, what is the revised India's GDP estimated for financial year 21 as per US based Goldman Sachs groups? That is, it is decreased to 0.4%. American multinational finance services company Goldman Sachs Group has predicted India's GDP growth rate for financial year 2021 at decrease of 0.4% for following the expansion of the lockdown. If we talk about Nomura Holdings, that is headquarters located in Tokyo of Japan, president and CEO is Konato Okuda. If you talk about Goldman Sachs Group, headquarters located in New York of US, chairman and CEO is David M. Solomon. Next one, name the Indian cricket who has been appointed as the brand ambassador of educational technological company LSA Corporation, that is Ajinkya Rahane. If you talk about this, LSA Corporation, headquarters located in California of US, co-founder and CEO is Van Yuan. Next one, Union Minister of Fisheries, Animal Husbandry and Dairy has presented the award to the winners of Startup India Animal Husbandry Grand Challenge recently. Who is the present Minister of Animal Husbandry and Ministry? He is Giriraj Singh. Next one, the US-based Carlyle Group has acquired 74% stake in which among the following India's animal healthcare company of rupees 1,587 crore recently, that is Sequent Scientific Limited. The Carlyle Group, it is an US-based private equity firm, acquired 74% in Sequent Scientific Limited, the largest animal healthcare company for India, for rupees 1,587 crore, approximately $210 million, for rupees 86 per piece. Next one, UK's GlaxoSmithKline has sold its 5.7% stake in which company for $3.35 billion in May 2020, that is Hindustan Unilever Limited. You talk about GlaxoSmithKline PLC, headquarters located in Band Food of UK, CEO is Emma Blamsley. Next, NanoSafe Solutions, the startup in which Indian IIT has developed and launched an antimicrobial and washable face mask, that is NSafe. It is launched by IIT Delhi. With increased demand of face masks to contain transmission of deadly COVID-19 virus, Indian Institute of Technology of Delhi startup company named NanoSafe Solutions has developed and launched an antimicrobial and washable face mask, NSafe, that can be reused up to 50 laundries. If you talk about Delhi, Chief Minister is Arvind Kejriwal, Governor is Anil Baijal. Next one, the Council for Scientific and Industrial Research, CSIR, has received approval from the Drug Controller General of India, DCGI, for clinical trial of which drug to treat COVID-19 recently, that is Favipiravir and Photopharmaceutical. Already, if you talk about my previous videos, I discussed about this Favipiravir drug. We talk about CSIR, President is Sri Narendra Modi, that is RPM, and Director General is Dr. Shekhar C. Mande. Next one, who has authored the book titled Finding Freedom, Harry and Meghan and the Making of a Modern Royal Family, that is Omid Scobie and Emmanuel Johnson. Next question, the time of remembrance and reconciliation for those who lost their lives during World War II is second day international event observed every year on May 8th and May 9th. The time of remembrance and reconciliation for those who lost their lives during the World War II is a two-day international event observed every year on May 8th and 9th to pay tributes to the millions of people who lost their lives during the Second World War. This year, it makes 75th anniversary of the World War II. If you talk about headquarters of United Nations, that is New York, of US Secretary General is Antonio Guterres. Next one, the internationally migratory bird day for the year 2020 was observed on May 9th. What is the theme of the day? That is, birds connects our world. It is observed annually on May 9th. The celebration campaign to raise awareness for the needs of the conservation of migratory birds and their habitats. This day was initiated in 2006 by the Secretary of the Agreement of Conservation of African Eurasian Migratory Water Birds, that is AEWA. The theme of this year is Birds Connects Our World. Thanks for watching. Please share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.